Hi, this is Shields from Down to the Bone, and you're listening to Spectrum with Thomas Grooms on 105.9.
Hi, this is Neil from Down to the Bone. When I'm in Washington, I always listen to Smooth Jazz on 105.9 WJZW. Happy holidays.
What are you up to? What are your future plans include?
Lots of alcohol and women. And stay alive, basically. Stay out of trouble.
Make it through the next 3 weeks.
Yeah.
How are you being received throughout the country?
It's been great, actually, yeah. This is our second time over in the States. And we've played a couple of the same venues, met some of the same people from the first time around. But this is our first time in Washington at the... what's this club called? This is our first time in Washington at a Nation, and we're really looking forward to it tonight. I think it's going to be a kicking night. I think we've got close to 2,000 people coming down to see us tonight, so it's going to be a good show, I hope.
What has impressed you about America so far?
Well, just the friendliness of the people that have been coming to the show and seeing us. I mean, the reception has been absolutely fantastic. I mean, you never know what to expect when you come over. And
you have two CDs out under Down to the Bone. That has to be quite an accomplishment.
The third is being made at the moment at home. So, and they've both done very well, the first two. I mean, the Urban Grooves, which has only been out a week, is outselling the first one. And there were something like 50,000 advanced copies on that, so we're really pleased with it, that.
This is okay. I write for the paper, too, so I can decipher this. The name Down to the Bone, its inception, and how did you get the band started? Who started the band?
Well, the actual creation of Down to the Bone is from two producers, which is Stuart Wade and Chris Morgans. They're back in England. It was really their pet project that actually started this whole thing off. I mean, and the name Down to the Bone came from when they were younger. They used to go to a club called The Bone. And, you know, they obviously one would ring up the other and say, "What are you doing tonight? Are you going down to the bone?" And it stuck. And they when they first created the Staten Island Groove, which was on a sampler CD, became so popular on the radio and everything, and then it sort of transpired that it was that popular over here as well, so they decided to make Down to the Bone a project and created the first album.
All the references to New York and Staten Island, I assume you were headquartered there while you were making the record. Is that where that came from or what? I know you did a lot of the work in England, but if, when you first came out, we thought you were from New York. You know, it was only a natural to assume that because of the references. But why all the New York references?
The reference is because of the just the influences of all the music that we were listening to when we was growing up and a lot younger. You know, was all sort of funk and soul and jazz based coming out of New York. So it was a natural progression to go that way and all the influences really. But it works.
Speaking of influences, who were yours when you were growing up? What keyboardist?
Keyboardist, I guess, guys like Herbie Hancock, Lowell Mays from the Pat Metheny Group, Warren Bernard, I believe he lives in New York. Is he Woodstock? Okay. Oh, yeah. And it's Woodstock, is it, this week, happening, the festival?
The festival's on. I don't know if he's playing there, but jazz stuff up there all the
time. Right, yeah, yeah.
He plays with Jim Weider, who's the lead guitarist. Yeah. He does a lot of stuff and he's a good friend of mine.
Yeah, older guys like Bill Evans, who's a huge influence, I think, on most keyboardists of today. Guys like George Clinton, a great fan of his on the funk side of music. Yeah, just absorbing a lot of American influence, I guess. You know, like a lot of the other guys in the band. Sort of.
Is there a possibility we might see a live recording of Down to the Bone to capture all the excitement of the audience and the band?
Well, I mean, we sincerely hope so. I mean, we've the live side of Down to the Bone has got so much energy. It would be a shame. Well, it'd be a crime really not to get it down on some sort of CD or. Of some sorts, anyway.
What's ahead for you in 1999 as we go into 2000?
Well, obviously, the next sort of few weeks here, we've still got another sort of 2.5 weeks to go of this tour. Then we go home and a few more dates back in London. Then it'll be a few weeks maybe a couple of months off, and then we're back here in the States in October for another tour.
Any memorable performances that come to mind where you were playing and somebody showed up that you didn't expect and they got up there and jammed with you?
Well, actually, no one's actually got up and jammed with the band. It's still in its early days, really, the band, as far as that much. I mean, they were still trying to get... There's not that many people, really, that know... You know, I mean, it's all thanks to the radio stations that we're that popular at the moment. But until we've actually done a few more tours over here and maybe get on the festival circuit, then the wider audience is going to get to know about Down to the Bone. So all that's in the future at the moment, so...
What is the lineup for Down to the Bone here in 1999?
We've got Schultz on sax with Adrian, who's... Schultz plays a tenor and Adrian's playing the alto. Then we've got myself on keyboards, Tony Remy on guitar. We've got a bass, which is Paul Turner. We've got Sadin Singh playing percussion. And we've got Tony Mason playing the drums, holding it together at the back.
That's incredible. And these guys have quite a resume. I mean, all the way from Bowie to Sade, right?
Mm. Oh, yeah. I mean the whole band is made up of very seasoned professionals. We've all been doing it for years, and music as well.
And let's not forget the brand new heavies.
Yeah, I'm still working with the brand new heavies at the moment, so I'll be back out here in the States again with them next year.
We'll see a new record from them?
Yeah, they've got a Greatest Hits, which is released next week, which has got four new tracks on it, and then we'll start after Christmas to start working on a brand new album with their new singer.
Well, gentlemen, best of luck. Next time you come through D.C., come up to the station. We'll sit down and do a little interview and get things on tape and have a good time.
Yeah, thanks, Thomas. Nice to meet you.
A long way from Brooklyn, man.
Let's go.